Welcome to UNI Knows. I'm Ashley Yates, and this is what I know. I'm standing around outside while Professor Shaw pretends to be a robot. You may notice that Professor Shaw isn't very active. This is because he's a solar-powered robot, and he's currently recharging his robo-batteries. He thought that would be the most exciting way to introduce our guest, Reg Pecen, and his studies of wind and solar energy. But he appears to be taking a long time to power up. So let's hear what
Reg Pecen knows.
Hello, my name is Reg Pecen. I'm a professor and program coordinator of electrical engineering technology at the University of Northern Iowa. And what I know is, right here at UNI, we are studying basics of electrical engineering technology, which includes circuits, electronics, control system, telecommunications, and power systems. The research we conduct at UNI is so important for future because we have limited fossil fuel resources here at United States and overall in the world. We study wind turbines, photovoltaic solar power systems, an energy bike, human power bikes, as well as the solar power lawnmower. Those are the simple applications that the people can get used to it in their daily lives. My passion is seeing more renewable energy applications, more sustainable energy solutions for us. Here at University of Northern Iowa, we have research and development of the solar boats. That's a specific lab here in the Industrial Technology Center. And every year I recruit 8 to 10 students from different majors. Every June we have to go to the World Championships where you see the state-of-the-art solar power boats come and compete. The solar boat project is an excellent learning opportunity for students because it has everything. It has a basic math science, it has electrical, mechanical, and arts, and at the same time, the telecommunications. Let's talk about a little bit wind power. Iowa is number 2 in terms of the installed wind power capacity, right behind the state of Texas. We see more and more wind farms around, small-scale wind power applications and residential applications. So in order to see better developments and usage, of course, we need a workforce. So at UNI, we also prepare students, interested students, for the wind power development. And that's what I know.
You may find this hard to believe, but Professor Shaw is now a wind-powered robot.